cases to them and there is ovarian mass, then they are very much in dilemma whether it is a malignant tumor or it is a benign tumor, because it is very difficult by ultrasound. So my talk is that it is towards more in OBGYN, but it pertains to radiologists, and because it is a tumor generation from molecular age, what we are doing nowadays, we are in molecular age that we are doing the DNA diagnosis of origin of tumor. Every tumor is a cell cycle disturbance. When there is a cell cycle disturbance, maybe a cell cycle in the skin, cell cycle in the ovary, cell cycle in the kidney, cell cycle in the retina, wherever there is a basal cell and there is a regeneration, there might be cell proliferation, and there is always a check on cell proliferation. If there is no proliferation check, then it will be unchecked proliferation leads to anaplasia and cancer in any faculty. Basic thing is, now I go little bit to where we do laparoscopy. We do laparoscopy in Siloam. And what is Siloam? You can see this is gut and this is the Siloam. This body is covered by skin and this gut is covered by endoderm. Skin is an ectoderm, skin and gut is an endoderm. In between there is mesoderm. You can say there is a mesoderm which is in parietes, which is mesoderm in the visceral area. If you see this mesentery by which gut is hanging in Siloam, where we do laparoscopic surgery, there is a swelling on either side of parietal mesoderm which is called gonadal ridge, and it looks like this. And do you know how testis and ovaries are developed? We develop our germ cell from yolk sac when we were in utero. So from yolk sac, these cells, they travel and they come into this gonad. Now if you see the gonad, and there may be a testis or an ovary, the gonad is having, one is germ cell, because this matrix is made for mesoderm, and very importantly, it is covered by an epithelium also. Maybe it is testis, maybe it is an ovary. But in 8 weeks baby, in 8 weeks fetus, it is undifferentiated. So I am not going into the detail how sex gets divided into male and female, and what is the conatal sex and what is chromosomal sex. I am not going into that. This baby is going to become a girl. That means these germ cells will be ovarian germs. There will be mesoderm and there will be covering of epithelium. Now, either in testes or ovary, if there is a tumor, then there will be three types of tumor. It may be from epithelium, it may be from mesoderm, that is mesodermal tumor, or it may be a germ cell tumor. In epithelial tumor, nowadays, it is told that epithelial tumor, which is the most common ovarian tumor, generates from outer or lateral most part of fallopian tube. What we were taught, that there is an inclusion of epithelium into the surface of the ovary, which invades the ovarian meta, this stromal area, and then it grows. When it grows, then there will be formation of epithelial tumor. If you go to the male side, this happens there also. But all my gynec colleagues and my ultrasound people are there. कितनी बार ऐसा होता है कि जब आप ओवेरियन ट्यूमर देखते हैं और जब आपके पास में एक अल्ट्रासाउंड की रिपोर्ट आती है दैट देयर इज एन ओवेरियन मास, इवन दो इट इज अ सिस्टिक मास, यू हैव अ वेरी बिग कंसर्न अबाउट गिविंग द डायग्नोसिस. व्हाई? बिकॉज दैट गर्ल और दैट लेडी विल आस्क, मैडम इसमें कैंसर तो नहीं हो जाएगा? हाउ कैन यू डिसाइड इसमें कैंसर हो जाएगा कि नहीं? वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट. नॉट लाइक सर्वाइकल कैंसर की आप एलबीवी देख लिया, पैप सीए 125 एंड अल्ट्रासाउंड इज नॉट एन आंसर. थिंग्स बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई इट इज बॉर्डरलाइन, व्हाई इट इज नॉट ग्रोइंग. एंड समटाइम्स यू सी इन एपिथेलियल ट्यूमर इट ग्रोज लाइक वेरी फास्ट. इसके बाद सो दिस इज एन एम्ब्रियोलॉजिकल हिस्टोलॉजिक ओरिजिन. एपिथेलियल ट्यूमर, जर्म सेल ट्यूमर एंड सेक्स कॉर्ड सेल ट्यूमर. इफ आई टेल माय गायनेक कलीग्स दैट व्हेन देयर इज एन एपिथेलियम व्हिच इज दिस एपिथेलियम मेक्स देयर इज अ देयर आर टू ट्यूब्स व्हिच इज मलेरियन डक्ट and Wolfian duct. This Mullerian duct make the fallopian tube and uterus. That means this epithelium can convert into fallopian tube epithelium, then it becomes serous cell. Most common tumor is serous cell because it most of the time which is malignant develops from outer part of the fallopian tube epithelium. There is a word called stick, that is serous tubular intraepithelial cancer. This is the new word and it is the new thing which came, that ovarian tumor which are most malignant are originated from fallopian tube epithelium. That means there is a fallopian tube epithelium, there might be uterine epithelium, there might be cervical epithelium, there might be bladder epithelium. There might be mixed epithelium. If it is fallopian tube, it is serous. How we classify? If it is fallopian tube, it is serous. If it is uterus, then it is endometrioid. If it is cervical, creates mucus, lot of mucus, then it is mucinous. It becomes bladder sort of type. It becomes transitional. Sometimes it become mixed. So this is the way we give a histological origin. You have seen few words. This is a histological origin. My question was why a girl or lady develops ovarian tumor? Why a person develops any tumor? That means if this cell, if it proliferates, then it proliferates for a number of times, after that it dies. This is called Hayflick limit. This is called Hayflick limit with all cells. This cell cycle which goes 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8 and all, there is a restriction. जैसे हम गाड़ी चलाते हैं, एक एक्सेलेरेटर होता है, एक ब्रेक होता है. इफ आई एक्सेलेरेट टू मच देयर विल बी मोर प्रोलिफरेशन एंड इफ आई टेक ऑफ द लेग फ्रॉम द ब्रेक देन द मशीन विल बी एक्सेलेरेटेड ऑलवेज. इन एनी ट्यूमर, मोस्ट ऑफ द ओवेरियन ट्यूमर, दिस ब्रेक पैडल हैज बीन रिलीज्ड. This brake pedal is being in check by few protein product, any protein product. This is the cell. Cell has a nucleus. We all have cells, we all have nucleus. Our all cells are my cells are all my cells, but they act differently. This cell contains nucleus contains DNA. this DNA, if we stretch it,